Good morning, students. See, last class I started Mahatma Gandhi's The Need for Religion essay. I have introduced the writer and the essay also to you. I believe you would have listened to those lectures. And today's class we are going to see the essay. So I have given a detailed summary here. You can take down these if you have a note in hand, and you can listen to the lecture. So I'm going to the lecture. The Need for Religion, this is the title of the essay. So let me first give you a meaning for the title. Explain the title to you. The Need for Religion. So this seems to be like a question, isn't it? The Need for Religion. So Mahatma Gandhiji raises a sensible question to his listeners or audience. Do we need a religion? And you see, this is applicable to all ages. Even if you are going to read this essay, if the coming generations after 100 years, this is applicable even to that age. Do we need a religion now? And if your answer is going to be yes, people will say that, yeah, you are a theist. So you are a believer, you say yes. And if you are going to say no, we don't need religion. Only fools need religion in this scientific era. We live in a scientific era. You all know that we live in a single touch. We get everything. We come to know about the world in a single touch. We live in a scientific era. So do we need religion in this century? And some of you might say no, isn't it? So this is a very good essay which makes us to think, you know, which gives us a very insightful thought of what is religion and what is the real understanding of religion. So how we have understood the word religion so far? We have always tried to connect this word religion with God. Thus, this word religion has only one meaning. That is the next question. So what is the meaning of the word religion? Does this word contain only one meaning? If you have understood the word with God, your understanding is wrong. So that is the essay about. So if you have tried to connect the word with God, that is wrong. So he does not talk, Mahatma Gandhi, he does not talk about God alone in this essay. So what are the other things that we must give importance in our life? That is highlighted here in this essay. The need for religion. Why do we need religion at this time? Okay. I'm moving into the essay. So I have started this essay with a definition for this word, religion. So what is religion? Religion is said to be a collection of belief, culture, and world views. See, I have not used the word God here. So it is only a collection of belief. That is religion. It's a belief based on our belief. And also culture. Culture, you know, which transfers from one generation to another. And next is view, the way you view world. It's only a world view. Okay, so religion is said to be a collection of belief, culture, and world views. That's all. The development of religion has taken different forms in different cultures. That is the change. It has taken different form. As the world changes, along with the world, you know, the term religion has also took different changes. So it has changed along with culture. And some religions place an emphasis on belief. And if you see, others emphasize practice. So it differs from religion to religion. Some give importance only to belief. And other religions, we might know only a few limited, but if you go to other countries, you come to know about many religions. So they might emphasize, those religions might emphasize only practice, give priority to practice. And Mahatma Gandhi's conception of religion, what is his understanding of religion, could be called modernist as well. So he himself, Mahatma Gandhiji himself, is a modernist. And he believed that all religions are equal. And all are to be tolerated. If all religions are equal, then all religions, all those different religions should be accepted, tolerated. And for Gandhi, religion